But this is where we start. Two suspects charged in an officer-involved shooting in Springfield facing the judge this morning. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome here to Western Mass News at Noon. I'm Taylor Jacobs. Now, they were taken into custody last night after police say that they tried to flee from police by driving right through them. Our Western Mass News reporter, Audrey Russo, joining us live from outside the courthouse with more. Audrey.
Two suspects were scheduled to face the judge. One of them already has and faced the judge in a wheelchair this morning, much more subdued from the situation officers described last night. They say the two suspects attempted to evade arrest by ramming their car into a police cruiser and then trying to drive through officers who were standing in the street. This all happening just around 8 o'clock last night. Police say they pulled over a car after witnessing a possible drug deal. The driver, Courtney Wilson, reportedly drove his car towards officers, and Springfield Police spokesman says those two officers, fearing for their safety, shot at the suspect, who eventually kept driving down Alden Street before crashing. The driver, Wilson, was taken to Bay State with a non-life-threatening leg wound. Now, Wilson pled not guilty today in court, and he's being held without right to bail this morning until a dangerousness hearing can be held. There was a female passenger, Regine Morales, taken into custody as well. Morales has not appeared before the judge yet this morning. This all happened near the Springfield College Arch, but the situation ended before reaching campus. According to a college spokesperson, at no point did they ever have to go into lockdown. Springfield Police spokesman Ryan Walsh says both officers followed the department's protocol for officer-involved shootings, but the shooting does remain under investigation. And right now, we are still awaiting Regine Morales to appear before the judge, so we're going to continue to follow this both on air and online and stick with Western Mass News tonight for the latest updates. Reporting live from Springfield, Audrey Russo for Western Mass News.